Stand by, there will be a news bulletin preceding the next program. Who wants to ring the NBC chimes? You want to ring it? Stand up. What's your name? Jim? Okay, you want to try this? Put this in your left hand.
I mean, look at me, Rochester. I've got bags under my eyes. I've got wrinkles. A receding hairline.
Keep going. It's still dialogue. Part of the
The Jack Benny program, starring Jack Benny, everything is so good. Watch us, Dennis Day, and yours truly, Don Wilson.
Talking with members of the cast of our Jack Benny Show recreation, and then we'll be tuning in for a brief dozen minutes to Cab Calloway and the Orchestra, broadcasting early in the morning on August the 14th of 1945, as we hear the first reports of the victory in Japan, bringing the end of World War II forward and at a close. Right now, here's the sound from our cassette tape of the month for February as we listen to The Shadow.
The hallway is abandoned precisely 9 o'clock, as the old woman comes slowly down the stairs. An oil lamp is flashing right now, and as the rest of the aisle comes right away from the upper door.
Who's that?
Who, me? Okay. Well, I'm giving you a level. This is Jack, and that's Mary.
Hi there. I'm giving you a level. I'm Jack, and that's Mary.
Hello, I'm Mary, and I'm giving you a level, too.
We're all on a level. The shadow knows. That's from our cassette tape of the month for February. This month we offer a great shadow doubleheader, two evil lurking programs on one cassette tape. Regularly $6.95, just $5.50 during February at Metro Golden Memories, 5425 West Addison Street, 2 miles west of the Kennedy Expressway in Chicago, or by mail for $6.50 when you send to the Hall Closet, Box 421, Morton Grove, Illinois, 60053. The Shadow. Brett Morrison stars as Lamont Cranston with Grace Matthews as the lovely Margot Lane in Terror at Wolf's Head Knoll from 1948, plus The Ghost Building from 1941, starring Bill Johnstone as the mysterious Shadow with Marjorie Anderson as his constant friend and companion, Margot Lane. These two chilling adventures feature radio's wealthy young man about town, clouding men's minds and solving mysteries. You'll want this hour-long take for your collection, The Shadow. Just $5.50 at Metro Golden Memories in Chicago, or by mail for $6.50 from the Hall Closet, Box 421, Morton Grove, 60053. And our cassette tape extra for February is very appropriate for Jack Benny Month. It's two classic Jack Benny programs, consecutive shows from 1948, the famous Your Money or Your Life programs, with Jack and the gang and guests Bing Crosby and Mr. and Mrs. Ronald Coleman. The 60-minute tape is only $5.50 at Metro Golden Memories in Chicago, $6.50 by mail from the Hall Closet. Now, if you order by mail, be sure to mention which tape you want, The Shadow or Jack Benny. They're $6.50 each, both for $13 from the Hall Closet, box 421, Morton Grove, Illinois, 60053. I'm Chuck Shane, and you're listening to Those Were the Days from 97 FM. This is WNIB in Chicago, WNIZ in Zion. Those Were the Days is sponsored in part by Cragen Federal Savings. Before you commit to any mortgage loan, Cragen Federal Savings urges you to ask your lender 7 crucial questions. Now, some lending institutions might answer yes to 2, 3, maybe even 4 of the questions, but Cragen answers yes to all these questions concerning adjustable rate mortgages. 1, is the first year rate dramatically below the average? 2, is the adjustable rate based on one of the lowest index rates? 3, is a closing date guaranteed within 30 days of application? 4, is the mortgage fully assumable? 5, can the mortgage be as large as $500,000? 6, is there a free credit line based on home equity? And 7, are there no points at closing? Cragen is proud to be able to answer positively to all 7 questions, and especially proud of the no points at closing policy, which lets you spread the cost of points over 24 monthly payments with no interest charge. For further details in the Cragen Regional Lending Center nearest you, call 889-LOAN. That's 889-L-O-A-N. Well, it's a very special day for us here at our Those for the Day studio in the Museum of Broadcast Communication. We have assembled perhaps the finest cast of radio performers assembled in the Chicago area in 45 years. Right? We'll see. Well, I thought you might like to meet the people who are going to do the voices on our Jack Benny recreation in another, 10 or 15 minutes from now. So I've asked them to step before the microphones, out of character, actually, to tell us a little bit about themselves. Our Jack Benny is a young man by the name of Gary Stan. Gary, welcome to Those Were the Days.
Thank you, Chuck.
You are from?
I'm from Kenosha, Wisconsin.
And you have, what do you do for a living?
Well, I produce educational and videotapes for the Society for the Preservation and Encouragement of Barbershop Quartet Singing in America, Incorporated.
Are you married?
Yes, my wife and 2 girls are in the audience today.
Okay. What is the daughter and your girl's name?
April and Liesl.
Okay, well, we're glad that they're here, and we're glad that you're here, too. And opposite you is Mary Livingston.
Hello.
Hi, Mary.
Hi.
No, you're not Mary Livingston. You're Kathy Canapasek, right?
Yes, Canapasek.
Oh, boy. Canapasek. What do you do, Kathy?
Well, I'm a happy homemaker and mother who pretends a lot.
Well, use your imagination.
Yes, that's why I'm here today, I guess.
And well, you're from where?
Chicago.
And whereabouts?
On the north side.
On the north side of Chicago. A couple of weeks ago, we had someone here who was from the north side of Sandwich, Illinois. Which is the top half of the double-decker, I think. Your children?
Freddie is 6 years old, and he's here today.
Mm-hmm.
And my husband is older than that.
What does he do?
He works at Grand Hospital.
Mm-hmm. In Chicago,
yes,
as
Chicago. Well, he's Vice President of Human Resources.
I see. Well, we may need him after our show. Thanks very much, and good luck.
Thank you.
Coming up in the role of Phil Harris is Barry
Rickard.
Barry Rickard. And you're from, Barry?
I'm from Westchester.
Westchester. What do you do for a living?
I work for AT&T Network Systems as a systems administrator.
What does that mean?
Basically, if people have problems, computer problems, people that work in the building, they come to our team,
mm-hmm.
and we try to help them.
Do you usually solve those problems?
I'm going to say yes.
Okay, and you're going to be, are you married, Timber?
Yes, I am.
Married?
I'm married. My wife, Linda's in the audience, and my father, Frank, and I have a 10-month-old son at home.
And what's his name?
His name is Matthew.
Is Matthew listening today at 10 months?
I hope so.
He better.
I don't know if he's going to retain it, but...
Okay, thanks very much, Barry. And now, in the role of Dennis Day is Ken Rivera. Hi, Ken.
How you doing?
Where are you from?
I'm from Dalton, Illinois.
Dalton, and you are a?
I'm a accountant. I work for Chicago State University, which is in the south side of Chicago.
Okay, and are you married?
Oh, no, I'm very happily single.
Oh, well, that's not that could be Dennis Day too, right? Okay, thank you very much. Rochester is played by Don Krause.
Yes.
Don, and you are from?
Northside Chicago.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a purveyor of liquid refreshments at sporting events, a beer vendor. I work at clubs, so the Sox games and the Chicago Stadium.
Oh, you're the cold beer man, right?
That's right, cold beer.
Let's hear that. How about that?
All right.
Give it to us.
Cold beer. Cold beer.
maybe not. Thank you, Don. Okay, and Dave Mayberry is, are you playing Frank Nelson part?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, Dave, where are you from?
I live in Des Plaines.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a marketing director for a corporate travel firm.
A corporate travel firm? Is that an unknown? This is not Wheel of Fortune, you know.
Travel master.
Travel master. And are you married?
No, I'm not married.
Okay, you're looking?
Not anymore.
Not anymore. I don't think our legal would do well, but I'm not going to touch this. Thanks a lot, Dave.
Thank you.
John Schaefer is Mel Blanc. And where are you from, John?
Lombard, Illinois.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm an unpublished freelance writer.
An unpublished freelance writer. Well, let's see. What have you written that has not been published?
Too numerous to name.
What kind of work do you do? What kind of writing do you do?
Mainly magazine stories and things like that.
Mm-hmm. And are you single or married?
Single.
Well, I just asked. I haven't asked anybody their age. I told them all I was going to ask their ages, but I knew that I was going to get 39 from everybody. So I felt this is not fruitful. Okay, John, thanks very much for stopping up here. And David Katz is Don Wilson. And Dave, what do you do?
I'm semi-retired. I work at the refinishing furniture.
Mm-hmm. And you're from where?
Oakland.
And I'm
married.
You're married and have a family of?
Well, I have two girls and I've got four grandchildren.
Okay, your four grandchildren. Do you want to give us the names? We'll put you on the spot.
Okay. let's see, Lauren, Kristen, Brian, and Jordan.
Pretty good. But what are their birthdays?
try to get
okay. Better luck next time. Okay, and Mr. Kissel is Mike Schwimmer. Hi, Mike.
Hi, Chuck.
Now, Mike and I worked together years ago over at that little station in Evanston when I had those were the days on Saturday afternoons, and I had a hall closet program in the mornings. Mike Schwimmer was the host of a big band and jazz disc jockey show in the afternoons. The Yesterday Shop.
Right.
And Mike, what do you do for a living?
I'm a jazz musician, and I'm a purveyor of old player piano rolls.
A purveyor of old player piano rolls.
Well, I sell them, but the P goes better.
Do you play them?
On my own piano, yes.
How would one go about selling piano rolls?
By mail, on an auction. You go right in and bid on them. Because they're really one of a kind items, so.
Okay, now you are a jazz musician, and where do you play?
I play at the Village Tavern in Long Grove, Saturday nights and Sunday nights.
And what do you play?
I started out as a washboards player, and I graduated into a drummer.
Is that where the drummers all start? Gene Krupa started out in a washboard.
I think so.
Okay, thanks, Mike. And we have a role in our script today of a receptionist, and this is Joan Lively. Hi, Joan.
Hi.
And where are you from?
Plano, not Sandwich.
Oh, you're the one from Sandwich, from Plano.
I have friends listening today.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just never make the right kind of sandwich. I know. Are you married?
Yes, my husband, a marathon runner, is here.
A marathon runner?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And how long have you been married?
32 years.
And what is your anniversary?
October
21st. October 21st?
Second.
Lose the dinner this year. Okay, and what do you do for a living?
I teach drum and music to children and have a ball.
Terrific. Where do you teach?
All over.
All over?
Community colleges, mm-hmm. and park districts, things like that.
Terrific. Well, we're glad you're here today.
I am too.
Great. And we have the Sportsman Quartet here. This is the Brandy Bunch. All right. All right, let's have a left to right here. The names are?
Dave Reiser.
Bob Hesselbart.
Dan Spengler.
And Tom Callum.
Okay, how long have you, let's take Dave, you want to tell us to speak for the group here? How long have you been singing together?
We got together about a year ago, and we've
enjoyed being together, so we did, kept singing together. We're all associated with Palatine High School one way or the other.
I see. What, in what way?
Well, I teach music at Palatine High School, and...
I teach chemistry.
Okay.
I'm a parent.
You're a parent?
Apparently you are. Oh, apparently you were. Yeah, we're either teachers or parents or both.
I'm both. I have two daughters at Palatine High School.
Okay, well, has it ever come into a situation where one of the teachers has to have a meeting with one of the parents and you're one of them?
Not yet.
You just start singing. Are you fellas officially members of the SPB whatever?
No.
You're not?
No, we're not, no.
Oh, I know there are people in the audience who are, and brother, you guys are going to have to sign up before this is over. Okay, thanks very much for being with us today. That's our cast, ladies and gentlemen. Sound from World War II for you before we go into the recreation of the Jack Benny Show, thereby giving our cast members here a chance to take a deep breath or two and get ready for the roles in front of the microphone. We're going to take you back to BJ Day now. The end of the war in Europe. August the 14th, 1945. The time is 1:30 a.m. Eastern Wartime. Cab Calloway and the orchestra is broadcasting a remote program from the Cafe Zanzibar in New York City. We have kind of telescoped this a little bit so you get the impact of the first announcements of the end of World War II as we tune into Cab Calloway and the orchestra. Early in the morning, 1:30 in the morning, Eastern Wartime of August the 14th of 1945. Obviously, Cab Calloway and the orchestra weren't listening to those reports. They were performing on the bandstand over there, so they didn't really know that the war had come to an end like that. And, of course, a lot of people at home were sleeping by this time at 1:30 in the east, although it was 12:30 here, 11:30 Mountain Time, and 10:30 in the West Coast. The West Coast probably got the first exciting news of this from the radio. And what an exciting time it must have been at the end of World War II.
those radio newscasters announcing all of this sort of thing, they really were, they didn't have any information. They just had the little scanned information coming over the wire services, whatever they were saying. And so they had to do a job with almost nothing. Those were the words we wanted to hear back at the end of World War II. Now, don't touch that dial. In just about 2 minutes, we'll be tuning in to our Jack Benny recreation. How would you like to get in on the biggest... Saratoga Naturally Sparkling Mineral Water brings you the Big Band Galaxy of Stars on Sunday, March the 6th at 7:30 p.m. at Center East, 7701 North Lincoln Avenue in Skokie. What a show this is going to be. The timeless sound of the Big Band era will ring with Maxine Andrews of the Andrews Sisters, Harry Babbitt of Kate Kaiser's College of Musical Knowledge, Johnny Smith's New Ink Spots, and Jimmy Rogers. They'll be together on the Center East stage for one performance only, an unforgettable evening of song and nostalgia. Sunday, March the 6th at 7:30 p.m., you'll hear Apple Blossom Time, By Mere Mr. Shane, Honeycomb, Kissing Sweeter Than Wine, Slow Boat to China, and Who Wouldn't Love You, If I Didn't Care, and the Java Jive. Great hits performed by Maxine Andrews, Harry Babbitt, Jimmy Rogers, and the New Ink Spots. Sunday, March the 6th at Center East, 7701 North Lincoln Avenue in Skokie. For tickets, call 673-6300 or Ticketmaster at 902-1500. That's 673-6300 or 902-1500. The Big Band Galaxy of Stars, March the 6th at Center East in Skokie, 673-6300. I'm Chuck Shaden. This is our Those with the Days program, sponsored in part by Cragen Federal Savings. In the past year or so, the annuities being offered through Cragen Federal have become increasingly popular with Cragen customers. The reason for this upsurge? High yield, tax deferral, and safety. As for yield, right now the current first-year guaranteed rate on these investments is 8%, but 8 is just the beginning of your favorable earnings situation. You see, there's tax deferral, too. As long as the interest earned remains in the annuity, you pay no state or federal taxes. And without Uncle Sam taking deductions, your deferred annuity grows at a more rapid rate. Safety? Although the annuity is not FSLIC insured, the legal reserve system requires that all annuities be backed by reserves sufficient to pay off all funds at any time. For more information on these high-yield tax-deferred annuities being offered through Cragen, call 889-1000 or drop by any one of Cragen's 23 Chicagoland Family Financial Centers. Cragen Federal Savings, now with over $2 billion in assets. You're tuned to WNIV Chicago, WNIZ Zion, 97 on your FM radio dial. Our Jack Benny Show recreation is next.
A-G-L-L-O. Those Were the Days presents the Jack Benny Program. It is morning, and we find Jack at home, looking at himself in the bedroom mirror. Rochester is making the bed.
You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a beautiful boy.
Rochester?
Yes, Mr. Benny?
Must you keep singing that song?
What's wrong with it? I thought that was one of your favorite songs.
Well, not today it isn't. I mean, look at me, Rochester. I've got bags under my eyes. I've got wrinkles. A receding hairline.
A receding hairline? Then why don't you put on the one that makes you look like Clark Gable?
No, not that one. It gets in my eyes. I'll have to get a trim. Besides, it doesn't help my wrinkles or these bags under my eyes.
What are you so worried about your looks for anyway, boss?
Because eventually, I'll have to go on television, and I can't go on looking like this.
You mean wearing your bathrobe?
No, I mean with a face like this.
Why not? Mr. Allen is on television, and the bags under his eyes take up half the screen.
Well, that's true. But Fred Allen is past hope. I've always been known as a playboy. What will everyone think if they see me like this?
I don't know. I'm still working on the playboy part.
Rochester!
Saved by the bell. I'll get it, Mr. Benny. Oh, you must have... been a beautiful baby. Oh, that's right. Sister Becky doesn't want me to sing that song. From Natchez to Mobile, from Memphis to St. Joe, wherever the four winds blow. Mr. Benny's a two-faced. We'll leave you to sing in the blues in the night.
Hello, Rochester. Is Mr. Benny up yet?
He's up, but he's down. He got up, then was down. Of course, he might have been down before he got up. All I know is, he's been down ever since he got up.
And I don't know he's on third. What are you talking about, Rochester?
Mr. Benny's feeling depressed because he doesn't think he looks good enough to go on television.
What is he talking about? He looks good enough. All he has to do is wear the one that makes him look like Clark Gable.
First, I gotta get it trimmed.
When is Mr. Benny going on television anyway, Rochester?
I don't know.
Then why is he worrying about his looks now?
He feels he's eventually gonna have to go on television, so he wants to look good.
Who's that, Rochester?
It's me, Jack, Mary.
Oh, I'll be right out, Mary.
I gotta go prepare breakfast, Miss Livingston. Maybe you can cheer Mr. Benny up in the meantime.
I'll try, Rochester.
Well, hi, Mary.
Hi, Jack. Gee, you're looking good this morning.
Gee, you really think so, Mary?
You look very becoming in your bathrobe.
Oh, I forgot to take it off. There it's off. But what else looks good about me, Mary?
Well, your baby blue eyes are sparkling.
No, Mary, that's lazy lagoon blue. Anything else about me you like?
Your hair looks nice.
Yeah, but that's not mine. Is there anything else you like about me?
I see you brushed your teeth this morning.
Mary, I said something you like that belongs to me.
Your nose looks nice.
Some compliment.
Why are you looking for compliments?
Because I want to know if I look good enough to appear on television.
And when is that going to be?
Well, I don't know, but when the network calls me, I want to be ready.
Look on the bright side. Maybe they'll never call you.
You're a fine person to cheer me up.
Well, I think you're worrying over nothing.
Yeah, it's lucky for you the doorbell rang, or I wouldn't have answered that last one.
Hiya, Jackson. Hi, Libby.
Say, Phil, how do you think I'd look on television?
Why, you're going on?
Well, not right away, but eventually I will. So how do you think I'd look?
Well, you just pull up a chair to the set and watch. How's that one, Liv?
Nice bit of evasion.
Huh?
Phil, enough with the gags. Now, how good-looking do you think I'd be on television?
Well, how good-looking do you want to be? If you put on the long, wavy one, you can look like Clark Gable. Or if you put on the crew haircut, you can look like Van Johnson.
How about if I want to look like Jack Benny?
Then put on the one with the receding hairline.
I'm not talking about that. Now, what about my face?
What about it?
Phil, Jack's afraid he doesn't look good enough to go on television.
Jackson, you look fine. In fact, if you put me on the show, you won't have to worry about looking good.
Why not?
Because everyone will be looking at me.
Oh, fine. And what do I do when you're not there?
You got me there, Jackson.
Phil, I don't want you anywhere.
Think it over first, Dad. I'd be great on your television show. Everyone would be able to hear and see me sing "That's What I Like About the South." Ham hocks and music. What more could you ask for?
How about an air freshener? Say, now there's an idea. If I could get a sponsor who makes air fresheners... No, only the guest on the show would want to use it anyway. Come in.
Hello, Miss Benny. Hello, Mary. Hello, Phil. how I looked on television.
How did you know we were talking about that, Dennis?
I was listening to your program on the way over.
Oh.
You see, Mr. Benny, you gotta wear makeup. So, no matter how rotten you may look, makeup people can fix you up, even if you're down.
I'll explain later, Jack.
I have to wear makeup, huh?
How do you know so much about makeup, Dennis?
My mother was wrestling on television recently, and she had to put on makeup.
Your mother wrestles on television?
Yeah. Her professional name is Mama the Masher Day. And if makeup can make her look good on television, Mr. Benny, then you've got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, but people don't expect wrestlers to look pretty. Well, I'm known for my good looks from the movies. But it's been a couple of years since I made my last picture, the horn blows at midnight. Don't you all think I look good in that picture? If you want to keep your job, say something.
Jack, it's just that you look good, but the picture didn't.
What do you mean, the picture? It didn't look good. What about the Academy Awards that year?
The horn blows at midnight didn't win any Academy Awards.
No, but I emceed the awards that year. So shut up and let's drop the subject.
Oh, boss, breakfast is ready.
Coming, Rochester. Come in.
Oh, Jack. Hi, Mary. Hi, Dennis. You too, Phil.
You know, Don, it's uncanny how you arrive when a meal is about to be served.
Oh, it's a sixth sense I have. How do you think I got to be so fat?
Gee, if you went on television, nobody would notice your face. The rest of you would take up the entire screen.
Are we going on television?
No, but we're still on radio. Jack, when are we going to start the rehearsal?
After I eat breakfast. Don, how do you think I'd look on television?
I don't know, Jack. Why?
Because I don't think I'd look good. What with these bags under my eyes, these wrinkles, a receding hairline.
A receding hairline?
Yes, and no jokes about it either.
Well, Jack, if you're really concerned about your facial expression, you can always have plastic surgery.
Plastic surgery?
Yes, but you can have those wrinkles smoothed over, your bags tucked in, and your nose corrected.
My nose? I thought I had a nice nose.
Oh, it's just a possibility.
Well, if you ask me, all you need is some beauty sleep, Jack. Then you wouldn't look so old and tired.
Old and tired? Well, I never said I looked old and tired, just wrinkled and baggy.
Some good makeup should take care of that.
Just have me on your television show, Jack, and then you won't have to worry about any of that stuff.
Boss, maybe you ain't eating right.
Well, what do you mean, Rochester?
Your breakfast is getting cold.
No, I'll be right there, Rochester. Don, how costly would plastic surgery be?
Well, I don't know, but I know it's expensive.
Hmm. I think I'll try Mary's beauty sleep idea. In fact, I think I'll take a nap right now. I didn't sleep very well last night worrying about my looks.
But, boss, what about your breakfast?
You eat it, Rochester.
That beauty sleep idea was a good idea, Miss Livingston. If Mr. Benny keeps it up, I'll be looking better, too.
What do you mean, Rochester?
I'll be eating better.
Rochester, go eat my breakfast.
Yes, sir, and sleep tight.
What about rehearsal, Jack?
Oh, we can rehearse this afternoon. In fact, we can eat lunch here afterwards.
No, thanks.
Why not, Mary?
Because we don't get paid till tomorrow.
Well, you can work it off doing dishes or something.
No, thanks, Jack. I've got food at home.
Oh, well, then we can go to your house for lunch. We'll talk about it later, Mary. I'm going to stretch out on the sofa now. I'll see you kids at 2 this afternoon.
Jack, before we go, can you listen to the Sportsman's Quartet? They've been working on a song for the sponsor. They will want you to hear what they've got so far.
Well, where are they anyway?
Right behind me.
Hum. Hum. No wonder I couldn't see them. Okay. Okay, boys, let's hear what you got.
Come to the superstore. Come to the appliance.
Go on.
Well, that's all they've got, Jack.
That's all they've got? Well, don't they realize we've got a rehearsal this afternoon? That we need an entire singing commercial? That the sponsor is going to...
6'2", eyes of blue, he'll look good on TV too. Has anybody seen our Jack?
Just forget it. Forget the commercial. Do a legitimate song and then get out of here.
Affair. And as we
Now, I'll just make myself comfortable on the couch and try to fall asleep. I'm sure I'll feel refreshed when I wake up, and maybe if I get enough of this beauty sleep, my bags will disappear. If not, I wonder how Don's suggestion of plastic surgery would be. Of course, I have to wear makeup and have one.
You see, Mr. Benny, you gotta wear makeup!
I'd be great on your television show.
You need some beauty sleep, Jack.
You could always have plastic surgery. You could have those wrinkles smoothed over, your bags tucked in, and your nose corrected.
I'm Jack Benny, and I'm here to have plastic surgery. Is the doctor in? Can I see him now? You can tell me, is he a good plastic surgeon? And his name is Dr. Nelson? And what is your name in case I have to sue? See. So what's your name?
Amy Cohen.
Now cut that out! Is there anybody else here who can help me?
Oh, senor.
Can I help you, Mr. Benny?
Mr. Kitzel, what are you doing here?
Ooh, I'm the interpreter.
Well, what happened to your hot dog stand?
I still have it. I bring it out during lunchtime. The only problem is the plastic surgeon likes to smooth out the wrinkles on the bones.
Oh, well, can you help me, Mr. Kitzel?
Would you like the people in the new with the mustard on top? Or the mustard in the new with the people on top?
No, I'd like to see the doctor.
First you should see the receptionist. Well, Mr. Benny, I must be going.
What?
It's lunchtime. People in the new with the mustard on top, just waiting like dinner all day.
Selling hot dogs during his lunch hour, and with smooth buns yet.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, I have an appointment to see Dr. Nelson about having plastic surgery done.
All right, then how are you going to pay for it?
Well, does Dr. Nelson need any chores done around the city?
No!
Well, how about laundry? I have my own washer and dryer.
No. How about money?
I'll discuss it with Dr. Nelson.
You may go in now, Mr. Benny.
Thank you. Doctor. I'm Jack Benny, and I'm here to have plastic surgery.
Oh, yes, you are, man. You've got wrinkles, bags under your eyes. Ooh, what do you have? Eyes, aquamarine blue?
No, lazy lagoon.
Well, we won't test those. Here, look through this book and tell me which features you want.
What do you mean?
Well, you can have an Errol Flynn chin, a Humphrey Bogart nose, a Jimmy Stewart forehead, a Clyde Gable mouth with a mustache if you wish.
Look, I don't want my features changed. I just want to get rid of a few wrinkles and bags.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Benny. You'll have to have a brand new face if you're going on television. Now, I'll go get my surgical equipment ready.
Go ahead. I'm getting out of here. Hey, the door's locked.
Of course it is, silly. How do you think I keep my patience? Now sit down and relax.
But I don't want plastic surgery.
It's too late now, Mr. Benny. I've got an appointment for lunch at Mary Livingston's at 2.
Well, so have I. Oh, I should have listened to my gang.
All you need is some beauty sleep, Jack.
You see, Mr. Benny, you gotta wear makeup.
I'd be great on your television show.
Someone help me, please help me. But I don't want a Bob Hope nose. Rochester, is that you? Get me out of here.
But Mr. Benny, you live here.
What? I'm back home. Oh, Rochester, what a nightmare. I dreamt that a crazy doctor was going to perform plastic surgery on me and give me movie star's features. Well, my face would have looked like a jigsaw puzzle.
Well, boss, I hope this puts an end to all your worrying about your appearance.
Oh, I'll say, I'm glad I look like me instead of a little like Errol Flynn and Humphrey Bogart and Clark Gable.
Just think, boss, if color television ever comes around, people will only notice your sensational blue eyes.
That's Lazy Lagoon. And I guess you're right, Rochester. Good night, folks.
Now, there's one last thing that I want to say to the members of the studio audience. You did a marvelous job. You applauded appropriately on cue. You laughed appropriately on cue. And the one last thing you have to do before you leave is to stop at the museum gift shop. And lay a couple of dollars on the counter and get yourself a souvenir. Thanks very much for listening to Those Were the Days and our Jack Benny recreation.
Chicago for one.
Okay, I think we have. All right, everybody hold still.